He was beautiful. He was handsome. He was funny. He was very gifted. He made my clothes. He made the children's clothes. And he spoiled me rotten.
Jerry and I grew up two doors away from one another in Brooklyn. He was just someone I knew I could count on. You know, someone that I knew would be there. He was my partner.
My husband was a firefighter, first grade Joseph Johnson Jr. He loved people, you know, he was always doing things, helping people.
I think that just kind of ingrained in him, you know, a life of service. I never concerned myself with his safety. It was just, you know, he went to work and came home like everyone else I ever knew.
The morning of September 11th, Jerry was straightening his tie. And the other fella said, what do you straighten your tie for? You know where we're going. We're going to the biggest disaster of our lives. And Jerry said, you always have to look good for the public. I worked in a radiology facility, so there were televisions in the lobby. And I saw one of the planes hit the building.
Patrick was killed on the evening of September 10th, 2004. I went and looked out my bedroom window and I saw an NYPD car pull up. I had a little bit of a panic attack and I thought, that can't possibly be what I think it is. And I said, Pat Hen, what are you doing here? And he was crying and he said, I can't believe I have to tell you this.
September the 1st, 1973. They said they lost him. We lost Joe at the fire. I let them talk. But it just, I didn't really hear them, you know, because I just felt, no, this isn't happening. It just wasn't real.
I kept on telling everyone, don't worry, everything's going to be okay. And the next morning when I woke up and he didn't call, I knew that was it, because he would never do that. He would never make me go through that. Not knowing where he was. He was my love. He would never leave me. Jerry lost his life September 11th, 2001. How do you make a new life when you were married at 21 years old and now all of a sudden you're widowed and you're widowed from your best friend? We attended many of the social functions within the fire department. And Answer the Call was one of them. My heart broke. My heart broke for those women because I knew that at any time it could be me. But you have a sense that they're going to be taken care of. I knew Answer the Call would be there for the rest of our lives. The philanthropy there is tremendous, but also the genuine care to the fallen firefighters' families. I was overwhelmed. I just couldn't imagine that they would be so benevolent.
The day of Patrick's funeral, the lineup while we were proceeding was just an unending sea of blue uniforms. I remember seeing it from the inside the limousine and thinking, how am I one? There's 25,000 police officers. Most of them are standing here on the street, Main Street in my town, and how am I the one in all of this? But I've learned I am not the one. I'm one of many, and we are all, you know, in this together.
It's a beautiful feeling to have the support of the foundation, to know that people really care, and to know that you're not going through it alone. I've been receiving support since the very beginning, and that's got to be 30 years. People talk about New Yorkers as they're rough and tough and unkind, but they're beautiful people. And I pray that they continue to support us, because we need them. All the New Yorkers that do it, thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Thank you for answering the call.